Hey guys, and welcome to week 3 of EKTV, and it's our series Revival Fire. And I'm so glad you're joining us this morning, wherever you're from. Why don't you give us a like at the bottom of this video to tell us that you enjoyed it. But the first thing we've got to do is we've got to start off with prayer. We don't have our physical prayer tent because we aren't gathered together, but what we can do is pray and be together in spirit. So we're going to pray as we go through the series. We're talking about God's protection. And so today we're going to pray for God's protection over our families, over all the health workers, over everyone and over our nation. Does that sound good? Awesome. Why don't you guys join me? God, right now we thank you for your protection. God, we thank you that you're sovereign, Lord, that you're above everything, Lord, that you're the head and not the tail. And so God, we pray right now, God, whatever anyone may be going through, God, if they're on the front lines, maybe they're just finding it hard with school, God, I pray right now they would know your protection. And as a result, God, would they know your peace? God, as they go into every situation, God, would they know that you're with them, Lord, that you're going to carry them through this, God, and we're going to come out stronger on the other side as a result. So God, we thank you that you're with us. God, we lift you up and we pray that we have an amazing day together in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, we're going to get into our icebreaker, and I'm going to invite up two of my favorite people, well, a person and a dog. This is Michelle, and why don't you give it up for our little doggo, Sadie?
Yay, Sadie! Do you want to pick her up for me while explain the icebreaker? Hi, guys! It's so good to see you. This is my beautiful dog baby, Sadie. She's so cute, and she is here to play with us today. So like Josh said, we're in week 3 of Revival Fire, and this week, you're going to be learning about chariots of fire. If you don't know what a chariot is, it's kind of like a big wagon and it's pulled behind a horse. Yep. And in the olden days, that's what they would race on. So you'd see these horse and chariots racing around a big stadium. Well, today, our chariot of fire is this little fireball. She's very fast if you get her at the park, but we're going to see whether Josh can manage how fast he can get her around this obstacle course. All right. Let us show you what's going to happen first.
I'm going to jump out of the way.
Yep, you got to jump out of the way. Maybe come this way, Josh.
All right.
So Sadie can get used to it. So she is going to try and run through the tunnel all the way down the ladder, and then Josh, she has to weave the cones, and at the end of the obstacle course, I want to see if you can make her sit.
All right.
We're going to time how long it takes our little chariot of fire, and then if you have a dog or if you don't have a dog, little brother or sister will work. How about you set up an obstacle course for them at home and time them to see how long it takes? All right,
awesome.
Sadie, are you ready, my darling? All right, she's just got to get her lead off, get her harness ready. Over here. Good girl. All right, she's ready, Josh.
All right, I think I got my secret weapon to make this work. You got a little rabbit.
All right, let's count down Josh and Sadie. 3, 2, 1. Good luck, Sadie.
Go. No, she's going to follow you.
Come on. You got to go back down through the tunnel.
This is great. As you can see, she's so well trained.
Come this way. Yeah, in the hole. She's doing
Yes, she's gone through. Come. Yes, down the ladder. Come on.
Round
she's going to weave
go,
through.
Sadie, go.
Yes, all right.
Oh, you sit.
Oh, would you look at that? Oh,
good
you can have
girl.
The bunny now.
I reckon that was probably about 30 seconds. So if you can beat. Oh, she's heavy, man.
She
30
is heavy.
Seconds, then you win the Chariots of Fire competition. It's a microphone. All right, we're going to get rid of her because she can't dance the way we can.
No.
But how about you get ready in your lounger home as Josh and I lead you in praise and worship.
Let's go.
Let's go to Auntie Larry.
All right, DJ, how about you hit that track, jump up on your feet. We're going to get into praise this morning.
Clap your hands, everyone.
Got a reason to sing, it's you. In every season, you're good, it's true.
Double step to the right, Josh,
I won't let my feelings steal my joy.
Jesus, a shout of praise. Woo! Wherever you are. You're so good. Thank you, Jesus. We lift you up in this place. Come on, we're about to go into a time of worship, and I invite you just to reach out to God in this moment, whether that's lifting your hands, going down on your knees. I don't know how you connect with God, but He's here to meet with you this morning.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, that you're our source.
Thank you. We lift you up in this place today, God. Would you be honored? Would you be glorified? Thank you, Jesus.
You are sweeping in. We are waiting here. You are all around. We can feel you now. Spirit, move. Do what only you can do. Spirit, we are desperate for you. Have your way in us as we open up. Touch our hearts afresh. We won't leave the same. Spirit, move. Do what only you can do. Spirit, come. We are desperate for you. Spirit, move. Do what only you can do. Spirit, come. We are desperate for you.
Sing it out. Thank you, Lord.
God Almighty, be exalted forever. God, we're desperate for your presence. Standing in your presence, have my heart surrendered. Here on holy ground, set me on fire now.
Confidence today as we explore what it means to be lit on fire. Lord Jesus, lit on fire by your Spirit, would we outwork all your promises for our life, Jesus. We have a confidence in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. That's what we're believing, is that today you're going to know what it feels like to have the weight of heaven behind you.
Absolutely.
To have a security and a promise because of God's angel armies. So, it's our favorite time, Josh.
It sure is. It is time for the message, and of your favorite people who you see at Shout at every conference.
Absolutely.
On EKTV.
She leads our massive department, all those big intermediates in the house.
Let's go.
Her name is Larry OG. How about you put your hands together at home for her as she comes to share the message with you?
Awesome.
Welcome back, guys, to our third week of the Revival Fire series. And we've had such a fun time doing the first 2 weeks. We learned about Moses and the burning bush. And last week, we were spending time with Helen, and we were talking about Elijah and up Mount Carmel. And we were seeing how they were worshiping all these other gods and all these other idols. And we learned that sometimes there can be idols in our lives, but we need to put things like God in front of them. We need to get rid of any idols that can get in the way of getting to God. So we learned about that, and we learned that the fire of God spreads, and we want to spread the fire of God just like these things. So that's a towel, some bread dough. We know that spreading means to open up. So this week we're going to be talking for our third week about a man in the Bible named Elisha. Why don't you say Elisha? That's right. So this guy, and the story of Elisha is all about how a Syrian army is coming to attack him. But he has a word from God, and he knows that God's army of angels is protecting him. So we're going to watch a movie, a little video right now, and the story of Elisha, and I'll see you guys back in just a moment.
A long time ago, the king of Aram chose a spot for the Israelites to fall into his trap. The ambush was a secret. The Israelites couldn't find it on a map. A holy man learned of the king of Aram's plot. I must tell my king, he quickly thought. This man was no ordinary Israelite. His name was Elisha the prophet. His gift was very special. Not even kings could top it. Elisha was a messenger of God and could tell others what God said. He could even warn leaders before evil plans had a chance to spread. Elisha told the king of Israel,
watch out! King Aram has set up a trap for your army in this place. It's an ambush you do not want to face.
The king of Israel warned his army not to visit that place. But the king of Aram found out and was furious. How could the Israelites find out? King Aram was very curious. The king of Aram called his officers and asked,
which one of you gave our secret away to the king of Israel? Tell me, fast.
Sir, Elisha was the one who told of our secret plan. He must not be any ordinary man.
The king of Aram sent horses and chariots to surround Elisha's town. He planned to stage a violent showdown. Elisha's servant saw the horses and chariots and was worried. But Elisha replied in a hurry.
Don't worry. There's no need to hide. We have God's angels on our side. And because God loves and favors us so, we can be confident we are safe. This I know. God, open my servant's eyes and let him see, so he knows that he's safe with God and believes me.
The scene was incredible. The servant was amazed. God's protection was visible. The servant knew to give God praise. The servant's eyes were open to see God's actions. When the Arameans eventually attacked, Elisha prayed with passion.
God, make the Arameans blind so that all they see is darkness before their eyes.
The entire Aramean army was blinded by God's power. They followed Elisha straight to the king of Israel in a matter of hours. As they entered the city, Elisha prayed from afar.
God, open their eyes so that they see where they are.
The king of Israel wanted to defeat the Aramean army, but Elisha had other plans.
Send the army back to their king and get ready to prepare them a feast. They've done enough for today and should be released.
Because of God's power and protection, the Arameans didn't bother Israel anymore. Remember, no matter what happens, God is fighting our battles in the midst of any war.
Wow, wasn't that an amazing video? I love that video. So we learned in the story about Elisha, and we learned that Elisha is a prophet, so he has a direct line to God. And God was telling Elisha the plans of the Syrian army. So the king of Syria was coming out with all these war plans, how to come to Israel and how to fight them. But Elisha already knew his plans, and Elisha was telling his own king of Israel. So every time the Syrians tried to attack, Israel was already there, and they couldn't attack them. So Elisha, we found how he was telling his king what was happening in the land of what the Syrians were trying to do. And we know that the king of Syria was getting really confused. And he was wondering, well, how does the king of Israel know what my plans are? How does he know? One of you guys must be a spy. And obviously, if your plans were being told to someone else, you would think that there was a spy, right? And his servants were the only people that knew his plans. So he automatically assumed, which one of my servants is a spy? And his servants actually said, you know, the king of Syria, we know what's happening, and we know that none of us are spies, but we know that Elisha is a prophet, and God has been telling Elisha what your plans are. And so obviously that made the king very mad. If someone was finding out all of your plans, you'd be pretty mad too. But the king was, God was telling Elisha his plans so that he could protect Israel. And I love that. Sometimes God will tell us supernatural things to protect us so we can get insight from God and we can get supernatural insight so that God is protecting us. So obviously the king was very mad and he had to come up with another plan. He had to devise something that would get Elisha out of the way so that he could attack Israel. And what he did was he came up with a plan where at night they would go to Israel and they would surround the city where Elisha was so that he couldn't get out when he woke up. And obviously, just like this guy on the screen, that would be pretty scary, right? What happened was Elisha had a servant with him, and when the servant woke up in the morning, he saw that they were surrounded by people, by horses, by soldiers, and chariots that were trapping them in, so there was absolutely no way of getting out. Now, his servant, he freaked out. I would freak out if I was surrounded too. I wouldn't know what to do. And his servant, he had no idea what to do. He was confused. He was probably scared and crying maybe. He couldn't see a good way to get out. Now, just like these soldiers down the bottom, there's pretty much no gaps that they could get out of. And that's how they were. Elisha and his servant were trapped. There was nowhere to go. And as we see on the next slide, we see that Elisha had this confidence. Now, while his servant was freaking out, he had no idea what was going on. He couldn't see where God was in this situation. Elisha was confident because he knew that God was protecting them. And his servant saw the calmness and the confidence that Elisha had. And so Elisha decided, you know, I'm going to pray for my servant. And the reason that Elisha was so calm was because he actually knew that God had his angel army up on the hill protecting them. And we see in the Bible, it says, do not fear, for those who are with us are more than those who are with them. And this is what Elisha said to his servant. And what this means is that God's army was protecting Elisha and his servant. And God's army was so much greater and so much bigger and more powerful than the army of the Syrians. And so Elisha prayed, and the prayer that he prayed was that his servant's eyes would be opened, that they wouldn't just be open to see the things in front of them, because obviously he could see that there was an army trapping them in. But Elisha prayed that he would have supernatural eyes to see God's army and to see the chariots of fire. And after Elisha prayed, the servant's eyes were opened. Now, this is a huge miracle, right? His eyes were open, and he didn't just see what he thought he saw before in his natural eyes of being trapped in. But when he looked up to the hill, all he saw was the entire mountainside full of chariots of fire and God's angel army that was protecting them. Now, that is so amazing. When we open our eyes, our supernatural eyes, we can see that God is protecting us. And I love in this story that we know that sometimes we can come up against things and things can seem scary and overwhelming, but we don't need to be afraid. We don't need to worry. We don't need to be scared, but we can take the same confidence that Elisha had and we can be calm and we can know that God's angel army and his chariots of fire are protecting us, and they're so much bigger than what seems to be right in front of us. We need to be like just like these big goggles, these binoculars over here, and we need to see past what we see in the natural. Man, God is so good and he's so powerful. When we can seem scared, just like the servant, we need to pray to God. I love how this story of Elisha and the Syrian army, it gives us so much godly insight. And what this means is we learn a lot about God in this story, and we can learn a lot about ourselves too. Over here we see Mr. Scooby-Doo, and we can see that they're looking pretty scared, right? Things can freak us out, just like the servant. He woke up and he was scared. He couldn't see a way ahead. He couldn't see how things were going to get better. He was freaked out. I've been freaked out before. Maybe you have too. What's something that freaks you out? Why don't you write it down on your journal, or maybe you can tell your siblings that are next to you. But maybe it's something like spiders, or maybe you're freaked out by heights. Maybe it's something a little bit bigger, like starting a new school. Maybe you're even scared to go back to school after lockdown. Maybe you're scared of a dream that you have that you think is so big, but you don't know how you're going to achieve it. And I'm here to tell you today that God helps us achieve these things. God helps us when we're freaked out. He helps us to be calm. He helps us to be confident, because we can know that God is so much bigger than the things that scare us. This lovely picture in the middle here is a picture of me. And this story is kind of like a metaphor. So when I was, I think, 10 years old, we moved towns. I used to live in Levin, which was all the way near, but in between Wellington and Palmerston North, so all the way down. And we actually moved up to Auckland. Now, this is about an 8-hour drive, so it's a very long way for a 10-year-old to move. When I moved, I felt a little bit like I was on the edge. I couldn't really see a good possibility. I couldn't really see what was going to be good, how things were going to get better, because I was leaving where I had grown up. I was leaving all my friends. I was leaving my number one place in high jump. I was the man. I was leaving all the things that I knew and all the things that were familiar to me, and going to a place that was completely, I had no idea. I had visited the town once, and it was just so new. I was freaking out just like the servant. And I saw that my parents were calm and they were confident. And so just like my parents, I decided to not be freaked out anymore, but I decided to pray and to pray with a godly confidence and to pray that my supernatural eyes would be opened, that I could see a better possibility. And I love that. God was on my side. God was helping me to be strong. And I knew that God's angels were surrounding me and protecting me. Now, this is a cool little picture of us and God. And God loves to tell us stuff. He loves to care about us. He loves to do things with us. And this is God giving us insight. You know, from this story, we don't just hear a story in the Bible and think, oh, that happened so long ago. How can that apply to me today? But we actually see this and we see, thank you, God, for showing me that I need to open my godly eyes. I need to open my spiritual eyes today when things seem to get a little bit out of whack, when I'm just at home and I feel like I don't have this big dream because I'm just chilling at home. Like, what can I really do? But God is whispering stuff into your ear today, and He's saying, I'm with you. My angel army is with you. And God at home wants to bring the supernatural fire onto your life. We learned about physical fires, but God wants to show you a supernatural fire today. So as we open up our hearts this morning, we're going to let God in, and we're going to let a supernatural fire come into our lives. I just want to pray with everyone at home today. And maybe you've been listening throughout this story and you've been saying, the story seems cool, but sometimes I do feel like the servant. I do feel like I'm kind of only seen in the natural. I'm kind of just seeing what's directly in front of me. And I feel a little bit trapped. I feel like when I want to do something, I can't really see it. But today you're saying, Larry, I want to have supernatural vision. I want to open my eyes and I want to see what God has for me. I want to see the way that God is protecting me. I want to see God's army. This morning, I want to pray with you. So if that's you and you think, yeah, I want this confidence, I want this supernatural vision, then just close your eyes and raise your hands. And God, we're going to pray today. So Lord, we thank you, God, that you're a God of miracles. We thank you that you're a powerful God. And Lord, today we pray that our eyes would be open. We pray that we wouldn't just see what's in front of us, but God, that you would allow us to see the things that you see. So Lord, we thank you that you're protecting us. We thank you for a confidence. And God, we pray today that we would experience a supernatural fire in our hearts. Lord, we thank you for everyone watching this morning. And in Jesus' name we prayed, amen. Well, thank you so much for spending time with us this morning. Stick around for the game, and we can't wait to hang out with you some more.
Hey guys, and welcome to our favorite part of the day, where we get to put all we've learned into action. Now, to start off with, we have a craft, and we learned about how God protects us, and we saw in the story of Elijah where there was a literal army of angels. So what we need you guys to do is to find every kind of craft thing you can find in your house. We've got wrapping paper, we've got paper straws and sellotape.
Some other ideas might be newspaper, yep. Paper.
Bubble wrap,
that's a great one.
Cereal box.
Tinfoil, cereal box.
You could use absolutely anything.
And eggs.
Your parents' shoes. Parents' shoes is a great idea for this one. Okay.
I don't know how well that would go down. But you need some eggs. Here you see, I have my carton of eggs. I've also got my trusty tape. What we want you to do is to try and create a defended egg. So you might not believe it, but deep inside this beautiful contraption is an egg.
Wow.
We want you to get to the highest point of your house. Maybe, don't go on the roof or anything like that. But just
your double
like,
bunk or something.
On the carpet. Find somewhere where it's not going to matter if you break this egg. But we want to see if you can be as good as God's angel armies and defend that egg if we drop it from how high, whether it's going to break or not.
So good. 100% that's going to crack if you're going to drop that now.
Well, we won't be able to check it, but this is the
idea.
I'm
sure we'll hear it. Oh, that sounded all right. Okay, cool. Well, we hope that you guys have fun making that craft. Make it as big and crazy as you can. But next up, we have our game. Now, you've been wondering the whole time, why, Josh, are you carrying this green ball? Well, we're going to be playing a game of hot potato. I know it's not a potato, and I know it's not hot. But you could heat up a potato, you could grab a tennis ball, you could grab anything. But we want you guys to play a game of hot potato with your family, with your bubble, whoever's there. And if it gets too easy, what we need you guys to do is between catching them, we need you to clap, you need to use one hand, stand on one foot, maybe even put on some costumes.
Yeah, maybe if you drop the ball, you have to put on a dress up. I'm sure you have some really embarrassing stuff you would love to see your mum and dad wearing.
Yeah, absolutely. So we hope that you guys have fun doing that craft and that game. And we cannot wait to see you guys next week. Have an awesome week.